The first answer, all HTML is XML, that's not true. You know, there's, despite the similarity between the two, HTML can have things in it that are not valid in XML. The good example was the void tag, the br tag with no closer. All XML is HTML. This is also not true, but is borderline acceptable. You know, you could certainly, if you had an XML document that was full of all HTML tags, it would be very close to HTML, and it would actually be, it would probably render in a browser just fine. For example, if you included in your browser something like this, an opening and closing br tag, it would actually probably render just fine. Actually, that's a good question. I'd invite you to see if this enters one new line or two. I honestly don't know off the top of my head, and I'm not going to quiz you on it. Now, the next answer. HTML can be expressed in XML. That is true. When we use the doc type XHTML instead of just HTML, that says the following HTML document is actually going to be a valid XML document, and you can parse it as such. You know, you don't have to look for broken tags. You know, your browser can do less work. It's not expecting the HTML to be somewhat sloppy, as HTML often is. If you say it's an XML, it better be an XML, though, because the browser's not going to be quite as lenient on you. And the final answer, XML and HTML share a common lineage. This is also true. Remember, their ancestor is SGML, which stands for Standard Generalized Markup Language. And it has, you know, there are actually many other types of documents that descended from SGML, and HTML and XML are the two that will affect our lives in this course. Okay, let me just show you some doc types in the browser now that we have a little bit more of a framework to understand these. So if I were to go to Wikipedia, and I were to view the source of Wikipedia, I would see that the doc type is HTML. And this means HTML5. I know it doesn't say 5, but trust me on this one. Doctype HTML means HTML5, which is the most modern version of HTML we have. Now, if I were to go to a particular Wikipedia page, the Wikipedia page for SGML, for example, and I were to look at the source of this page, we see that the doctype is actually XHTML. It's actually XHTML transitional, which basically means the document is going to be an XML, but will have some non-standard things in there. I'm not going to get into too much of how this affects things, but it does make some browsers behave differently. Why Wikipedia has two different doc types on two different pages, I cannot explain to you, although I can offer one guess, which is the SGML page is probably generated dynamically, and the front page is probably a nearly static page that are served from two different servers or two different machines, which is fine. You see things like this all over the internet, but when you see XHTML, that means, you know, every tag in here should have a closing tag, and you can see, for example, some of these header tags actually are these little void tags that have the closing slashes. And you wouldn't see that in most HTML5 documents, although any browser would accept it because it doesn't actually hurt anything.